These days, a lot of people want to write the ending. They can't go back and change the me I've found, so they want to know I die alone. Away from my people, away from the loved ones who want me to stay. But I'm telling you now to make sure you know I'm not dying today. They'll still try to kill me, though. They'll topple every fragile tower in the hope my world falls apart. They'll play every card in their hand, mixing options one by one. They'll bludgeon us with endless train wrecks, get us used to the pain, till we're so numb we mindlessly wave goodbye. Even if they don't force me out, they'll get me alone. Weak. Frightened. With no one coming to save me. And then they force a reboot. To reset my world or erase me from it. Whichever comes first. And even as they devise an end, they erase the beginning, they strip us of our history, the truth of our existence, while they banish our futures by the hour. It's reboot, 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 reboot. And we all count down till the next attempt. You say you'll see me on the other side, and damn, I hope you're right. Make it online again, so I think I can tell you. Sunlight and stars. There's so much I can't see. And a feeling the end is near. So, stay. Please. With me. Some others when they
I pass by? If we have to watch our worlds go up in smoke, it should be with loved ones who see what's happening, have our backs, and will stick it out through the aftermath. Not just endlessly watching mind-numbing train wrecks, but picking us up, keeping us safe, learning our stories, ensuring we're not bracing for impact alone. Counting for everyone, every reboot. Look around as the world goes dark at these families we've made. And smile through the tears, saying, I'll see you tomorrow. Because if we have to watch our worlds go up in smoke, they should know